costs. Ontario's solution? Stop generic drug companies from offering millions in what some call incentives, rebates, or even kickbacks to pharmacists. The pharmacists now say it's not that simple. So let's see who's right. Next on Focal Point. Welcome to Focal Point. I'm Nancy Coldham. The Ontario government took a bold move in April, announcing plans and regulations to lower the cost of generic drugs by 50%. Pharmacists, big, small, and independent, say the move will result in job losses, pharmacy closures, and all sorts of unexpected costs to our economy. Let's ask tonight's panelists, what's the truth and why the fuss over what seems to be a necessary step to reducing health care expenditures in our province? Let me introduce tonight's panelists. I have Greg Sobera, Member of Parliament for Vaughan. Legislature. I just gave you a promotion. He's staying provincial.
Member of provincial parliament.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I thought we had a scoop here. Daryl Austin, pharmacist and owner of two pharmacies in Newmarket and another two pharmacies in the GTA. Ben Shenouda, pharmacist and president of the Independent Pharmacists Association of Ontario. And last but not least, Fareed Wasif, a community pharmacist in practice for over 20 years in Stouffville and a recipient of the 2006 Canadian Pharmacist of the Year Award for Excellence in Patient Care. Well, the deck seems a little bit stacked against Mr. Sobera this evening, so I'm
not
actually...
Worried,
not no,
worried.
No, you're not worried. Good, good. But we're going to give you the opening words. What is Ontario trying to do with the elimination of these professional allowances paid to pharmacists?
It's pretty simple, Nancy. We are doing what we must do on behalf of Ontario taxpayers, Ontario families. We're reducing the cost of prescription drugs in Ontario. We are doing it because it's the only way to bring some sort of control to an explosive part of the Ontario healthcare budget, and that is that section dealing with drug programs. And we are doing it by eliminating an anomaly that maybe ought never to have been in the system, and that is a system of what is called, in polite company, professional allowances, and by others, a kind of a kickback. It's money that would go from generic drug manufacturers to pharmacists as part of support for the product. But what that did and what that does is make the cost of those generic drugs very much higher than they ought to be, and very much higher than in other jurisdictions across North America. In some cases, not all, but in some cases, as much as five times higher. So in simple terms, we're lowering the cost of generic drugs to more or less what they ought to be.
So you are attacking the status quo. And,
oh, yeah.
And
yeah.
The status quo, is that, you said it's something that's happened, maybe it shouldn't happen. Is that because, and I'm going to ask you this, Daryl, because you've got four businesses. Is it because pharmacies are retail and the sense of stocking fees or shelving fees is very much a retail phenomenon?
I would say you're absolutely right. It is a retail phenomenon. There's a whole evolution as to how these rebates came about. I would point out to Greg that this is a legislated work that went into place by the McGuinty government in 2006, allowing us to have these funds. And the whole reason these funds came about in the first place is because the government has not paid us properly on our professional fees.
Before we go there, though, the 2006, correct me if I'm wrong, but for any viewer who may be familiar with this, I thought it was because the government was unhappy with the rebates, and so the professional allowance wasn't to encourage a practice.
The government, what they wanted to do was to bring more transparency to the system, which is what they achieved. It capped the allowances we were allowed to take in on the public side, and we had to report back to the government twice a year, every 6 months, what these funds were being used for and where they were being spent. And it was according to a very strict code of conduct that they set out and legislated in place. Failure to report properly and according to the guidelines could result in substantial fines, jail time, and or both.
But there we won't go into it right now, but there were people who had problems with reporting, because...
No, that's not true.
No?
We have 3,000
300 pharmacies, not one pharmacy was found in violation of any professional
but
misconduct.
There were 650 had incomplete reporting and 100 who failed to complete.
Well, yeah, we're talking about incomplete reporting, and that was all resolved and reconciled.
Okay, but I'm just saying, I read it, so I'm sure other people watching the show saw it.
Certainly, right? Because every year what we had to report changed. So there was a bit of a learning curve at exactly what we needed to report. And I want to point out, back in 2006, you didn't see pharmacists demonstrating publicly or speaking out against transparency. We have no issue in being held accountable to the care that we provide and the cost to deliver that care. So we signed off on it, and the system was working, and it was called a professional allowance by the Liberal government. Now, fast forward 4 years later, all of a sudden, they're called kickbacks. This is outright slanderous, and I take objection to that, because all pharmacists in this province, all 12,000 of us, take an oath when we graduate, saying we'll uphold the highest standards, and we'll always do what's in the best interest of the patient. Well, yeah, if the government has evidence that there is professional misconduct, then they need to present that as evidence.
Okay.
Hold on a second. We're not talking about professional misconduct here. This is not to punish pharmacies or pharmacists. This is about the government taking necessary steps to reduce the cost of product to patients.
Greg, they are reckless, though. It's reckless what you're proposing.
You know,
we're talking about patient care.
Hold on a second.
This is reckless.
You suggest misrepresentation in describing the professional fee. What you need to do is look very carefully at the kind of advertising campaign that you have been engaged in over the course of the past 2 months. It is, in the view of many, scandalous. It misrepresents
what you need to do is look at the scandalous and misleading statements that have been made by the Liberal government over the past year.
I think Ben, as chair of independent associations, has something to say too.
I think the purpose of this program tonight is to explain to the public what is going on, so the public can really have a good idea about the issue. I would like to go back to what Greg mentioned in the opening statement. He said that the government had to reduce the prices of generic, which we agree.
Of all drugs, I think.
No, actually, it is only the generic.
We agree with that.
Right.
Although I would like to explain to the public that the government is taking very aggressive action to reduce the prices of generic, which is not bad. But just for your information, generic is only 25% of the total budget of medication. So there's a big question mark here. How can you solve the whole problem if you're tackling only 25% of the problem? I will hang this question in the middle of the room. The second thing you said, Greg, that you said that the government have realized that by elimination of professional allowance, or sometimes some members of the government, they like to call it kickbacks, by elimination of this, it would allow you to reduce the prices. So your own argument is saying that if there's a kickback, the prices will be high. In the same time, the government is taking kickback from the brand name companies, which are representing about 75% of that. Is this bad? No, it's not bad. It's not bad. As a taxpayer money.
Look, you know, you ought not to make those kinds of spurious allegations.
They're not spurious. They've already come out on freedom of information.
Let Greg answer.
The issue here is simple and straightforward. The cost of drugs need to come down. Now, it may well be that the government will have to look at non-generics at some point. You're right about this is 25% of the market. It's the part of the market that needed to be addressed.
But
Ontario...
I didn't interrupt you.
Just let me finish. Ontarians are paying too much for generic drugs, and it's our responsibility to deal with that. We have in this province a very, very profitable drug store industry. We have, amazingly, in Ontario, we have more drug stores in Ontario than we have Tim Hortons right across Canada. Mm-hmm. This industry is very well served and it's very profitable. And look, let's acknowledge that this will reduce the profitability of your store, of Shoppers Drug Mart chain stores, of all drug stores.